Welcome to the Stop Workplace Drama 8 Steps of Empowerment Learning System. I'm Marlene Chisholm, the author of Stop Workplace Drama and the developer of this training system. And I travel around the country offering this training for associations, small businesses, and corporations. And you know, in today's business world, when competition is fierce and economic challenges are intense, cutting drama in the workplace has never been more essential. But one thing that distinguishes my work from other experts is the emphasis I also put on identifying and eliminating drama on a personal level. I'm so clear that although there are some boundaries between our personal and professional lives, I'm certain that what impacts us on a personal level also impacts us professionally and vice versa. It's my intention in this program to illustrate the intimate connection between personal drama and workplace drama and why that is some of the focus of this work that we're going to be doing together. And it's about your personal development using this same methodology that I used for writing the book Stop Workplace Drama. Now, because I know that there's different needs for different businesses, organizations, and associations, I've developed this workbook with modules in a way that can be customized to your needs. And I want to go over that right now so that you will understand how to get the best out of this program. Each module is numbered from 1 to 8. This represents the 8 sections in the book. And you're going to go through and you're going to see the labeling system as I deliver this today. You'll see section 1 has 1.2, and then like in section 2, when you get to that, it's 2.0, 2.1, 2.2, and so on to module 8. This is going to help us to follow along together on these videos and to pause the video when needed. Within each module, there's some specifics that I want to point out before we begin. There's number 1, the sidebar in the pink, which is on the right area. Number 2, discussion points. Number 3, exercises to complete. And number 4, there's some self-study sections. So let me talk briefly about each of these. The sidebar in pink are the areas that usually relate to the workplace in some way. So if your organization, business, or association wants to focus as heavily, you know, in the workplace arena, then you can elect to use some of these sidebars for your group discussions or for additional trainings to gain knowledge and clarity about your workplace. Or you may elect to integrate these sidebars into the main content. Now, as I go through this training with you, there's some times that I do add in the sidebars, and there's other times that I skip one or two of the sidebars. Now, any part of this module can actually be used for discussion later on or even today. So since I'm not here with you, this is something that you have to do through facilitation. There is a leader's guide that's included, and when you decide to use that, it'll give you ideas for facilitating discussion. Now, while I'm delivering this presentation, I'll make mention of times when a discussion would be valuable, so you can make notes of that on your learning guides and your modules. Now, let's talk about the exercises to complete. There's plenty of places in these modules where I give instruction to check off items or fill in the blanks. Any of these exercises can be done in one of several ways. If it's simple, you can do some of these while I'm speaking, and I encourage you to do that. There may be a couple of times when I give you like 30 seconds of silence to go ahead and do some of these exercises during this program, because that gives you time to process and to go ahead and get that done. At other times, you'll want to fill in some of the exercises maybe before watching some of these videos. For example, on 1.7, if you're able to go there, you'll see that there's 4 questions under the subtitle Exercises to Complete. Now, you can either do these on your own time after the video. So that's just an example. Any of these exercises, as I said before, are also great roundtable conversations, conversation starters, icebreakers, and discussion points. You'll see that the modules clearly indicate which pieces are good to stop for discussion, either while listening or after viewing this video. So it's up to the trainer or the facilitator. Now, finally, let's just talk about the self-study sections. Anywhere where you see a fill-in-the-blank or a series of questions, that's an area where you can do some of your own self-awareness work. You don't always have to be in a group. You can take this home. You can do it on some downtime. And then when you do have a group meeting, your facilitator can use these sections for discussion. So as you can see, these modules are very easy to use. You have a lot of flexibility to offer. You can use this program as a self-study, a group study, or an ongoing series with very rich discussion and opportunity for self-reflection to enrich you both personally and professionally.